This is honestly the hardest interview I've done since I've begun here on After the Bell, because this is the only interview that I could potentially get in trouble for when I actually leave the studio.
Yeah, so you better watch it.
My producers were like, hey, what do you want to talk to Carmela about? And I said, I don't know. I live with her. We talk all the time, basically all day, every day. This shouldn't be a problem.
Let me interview you. Can I?
All right, please. Let's do it. Let's flip the script here. It's Valentine's week. Let's flip the script here.
Okay. Well, can I say something before I interview you?
Sure.
Okay. So it's Valentine's Day this week. And last week I get a delivery of these amazing bouquet of like 24 roses with this beautiful message on the card. It doesn't say happy Valentine's Day or anything like that. So I'm like, oh my gosh, what did I do to deserve this? And you're like, oh yeah, you're welcome. No big deal. So when I see you in person, I'm like, what did I do? And you're like, well, to be completely honest, I entered the wrong date and got you the flowers on the 4th instead of the 14th.
You can't fault me for being honest. I could have tried
to
take the credit.
I could have lied and just been like, yeah, of course, you're just amazing and you deserve flowers, period.
But is that the interview or that was just the prelude?
You're ridiculous.
Well, you asked to interview me on my show, and I'm giving you the floor.
I know, and then I just got flustered. Okay, this is harder
see,
than
it's, a, yeah, than yeah, see?
Okay, I have a question for you. What is it like to date the most amazing, talented, driven, charismatic superstar in the WWE?
Well, I will ask Otis, because he is my other guest on this show. On this same episode, so take that.
Thanks a lot, babe.
So now you find yourself back in the fray on Friday Night SmackDown. How's that for a segue? That was maybe my worst one ever, but I told you I'm very flustered right now because of that meat locker you stuck me in yesterday. Maybe I should elaborate that we actually went to this pretty amazing wellness spa outside of Pittsburgh, and for the first time, I experienced cryotherapy, which I never in a million years had any interest in, really, or need for, because I am not an athlete in any way, shape, or form anymore, as you so often remind me. So it was, so I got down in my underwear in front of a perfect stranger and put AC/DC on the radio and went into a walk-in closet that went down to, what, negative 170 degrees?
Yeah, it was awesome. And I mean, you guys, I dragged him along with me. Like, I didn't think you would actually like it. So we did that. We sat in the sauna for, like, what, 40 minutes? It was, like, 100. What was it up to? 140 degrees or something? Super hot. And then we did IVs. So we had a full-on day of wellness. And I was very proud of you.
So we super cooled my body. Then we super heated it. Then we put a whole bunch of vitamins into my veins. And
then we came home and drank wine, so it kind of like negated everything.
Head over to Apple Podcasts, Spotify, or Google and type in WWE After the Bell. Subscribe right now and never miss an episode.